In 1974, a group of farmers in remote China was digging for a well when they made one of the greatest archaeological discoveries of the 20th century. Buried beneath the earth, thousands of life-size statues of Chinese soldiers, an entire army of terracotta warriors. Since its discovery, the terracotta army has attracted tourists by the thousands, including President Ronald Reagan. The statues date to 209 BC. Their purpose? To guard the tomb of Shi Huangdi, China's first emperor. In the year 246 BC, China was made up of seven warring states. One of the states, Qin, was ruled by a 13-year-old king named Zhao Zheng. The reason why China suffers bitterly from endless wars, he said, is because of the existence of feudal lords and kings. To increase the power of the Qin Kingdom, King Zheng and his army began conquering neighboring states. This led to 20 years of warfare, as he brought more and more kingdoms under his rule, ultimately unifying China. By 221 BC, after conquering all of the states, he named himself Shi Huangdi, or First Emperor. To help rule his empire, Shi Huangdi embraced legalism, a philosophy that said to achieve order, a ruler must pass strict laws and enforce harsh punishments. This Shi Huangdi did ruthlessly, torturing and killing his critics, enslaving criminals, and burning books on topics other than medicine and agriculture to end dissent. To maintain power, he forced nobles to move into his capital at Xianyang. To help further unify China, he instituted standardized weights and measures, introduced a universal currency, and created uniformity in Chinese writing. Workers repaired roads and built canals, improving China's transportation system. However, the most celebrated achievement of Shi Huangdi's rule is the construction of the Great Wall of China. Originally built in sections in various states to defend against raiders, Shi Huangdi ordered the walls to be joined. The effort demanded hundreds of thousands of laborers working year-round for several years. Many lost their lives in the process. At its greatest extent, during the Ming Dynasty, the Great Wall spanned more than 5,000 miles across northern China. Though his accomplishments were many, Shi Huangdi would not live to enjoy them. He died at the age of 50 from mercury poisoning. Ironically, the poisoning was caused by pills that were meant to give him immortal life. But his memory lives on in his Great Wall, his terracotta warriors, and a unified China that today ranks among the world's greatest powers.